Why not just go ahead and do the controversy now if the
committee is not? Yeah, we're building the wall. People don't understand that. They're starting to learn. We're spending a lot of money that we have on hand. It's like in a business, but we have money on hand and we're building. I would say we will have 115 miles of wall, maybe a little bit more than that very shortly. It's being built. Some of it's already been completed. And in San Diego, if you look, it's been completed. It's really beautiful, brand new. We have other wall that's under construction, and we're giving out a lot of contracts. So we're building the wall. It's getting built one way or the other.
We are
doing things right now. I mean, we're building it with funds that are on hand. We're negotiating very tough prices. We've designed a much better looking wall that is also actually a better wall, which is an interesting combination. It's far more beautiful and it's better. It's much more protective, but it looks better because the walls that they used to build were not very attractive. I actually think that's possibly part of the problem, but the real problem is we need something. We have to have a very strong barrier, but we're building a lot of wall right now as we speak, and we're renovating a lot of wall. And we're getting ready to give out some very big contracts with money that we have on hand and money that comes in. But we will be looking at a national emergency because I don't think anything's going to happen. I think the Democrats don't want border security. And when I hear them talking about the fact that walls are immoral and walls don't work, they know they work. I watched somebody being interviewed the other day by a very good anchor. And the anchor actually was getting angrier and angrier as they tried to explain how a wall doesn't really have that much of an impact, and yet thousands of people are on one side of the wall and nobody's on the other side of the wall. It was actually laughable and really horrible in the same breath. So that's the way it is. You know, if you look at El Paso, if you look at certain places, but El Paso was one of the most dangerous cities in the whole country. Once the wall was completed, it became one of the safest immediately. It wasn't like it took 5 years. Some of you know this. Immediately, it became one of the safest cities in the whole country. So we're building the wall. A lot of it is, I mean, the chant now should be finish the wall as opposed to build the wall, because we're building a lot of wall. And I started this 6 months ago. We really started going to town because I could see we're getting nowhere with the Democrats. We're not going to get anywhere with them. It's going to be a part of their campaign, but I don't think it's good politically. And I think Nancy Pelosi should be ashamed of herself because she's hurting a lot of people. I think the Democrats should be ashamed of themselves. Now, in all fairness to the Democrats, many of them want the wall, and I see it. They're just dying to say what they want to say, but they can't say it as well as they would be able to if they were allowed to do it. Yes?
Mr. President, so are you saying now you believe that on February the 15th, the only option you will have left is either close down the government or declare an emergency because you don't have any faith that this committee will come up with an answer? And if you do declare an emergency, are you concerned that you will almost be immediately and be enjoined by some court in the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals District?
Well, we have very, very strong legal standing. It would be very hard to do that. But they tend to go to the Ninth Circuit. And when they go to the Ninth Circuit, things happen. For instance, the ban. It missed and then was approved in the United States Supreme Court, where we have had a very good record. They go to the Ninth Circuit. In many cases, and in fact, in most cases, it has nothing to do with the Ninth Circuit. It's a shame what they do. So let's see what happens. I can only tell you this, John. We have very, very strong legal standing to win. We are doing it regardless. I mean, we haven't declared the national emergency yet, yet we're building a lot of wall. We're continuing to build a lot of wall with, as we would say in business, cash on hand. And we're negotiating tough prices. We have a great system, a great wall system. It's very uniform. They used to have all these different systems. Nobody knew what was going on. We have a very good, solid system that looks good and is very powerful as a wall.
But are you saying now you expect to declare a national
emergency? I don't want to say, but you'll hear the State of the Union and then you'll see what happens right after the State of the Union, okay?
Well, are you going to wait until February 15th to do
this? Yeah, we're building now. I mean, the one thing that I'm trying to stress to people, and I wasn't before because before it meant less, but when I see the obstruction, when I see the tremendous obstruction by Democrats, knowing that the only saving of our southern border is the wall. I mean, you look at these towns. Before the wall, they were crime-ridden. And now, the wall get filled. We put up a wall in a certain area, and all of a sudden it went from being a horrible hellhole into something that's really safe. They can't even believe it. The mayors can't even believe it. If you ever took some of the walls down in California, for instance, one story in San Diego, they were begging us to build the wall. I mean, they were putting pressure on us, that area of San Diego, where people were rampant going through. And you'd have a lot of security, but the security could only do so much. When, as an example, when you have these caravans that are going to be hitting, we've done a great job with the caravans, an incredible job. And most of them have gone back where they're staying on the other side of a wall. They haven't been coming in for the most part. But we've done a great job. We don't have the ammunition because we don't have the barrier. But it's been really amazing to see the difference when you have it and when you don't. It's incredible to see the difference of an area on the other side of a barrier. So, you know, the old expression, walls work, whether you like it or not. In Israel, they have a wall, and it was 99.9% successful. And ours are, too. When we have it, we're going to be starting in a certain way. We have a few of them, a few areas that we're starting where they catch up. Once you have the holes in the middle, they just spread, sort of like water, they just spread in, but you have to have it. So when you talk about the committee, I can tell you the Republicans want to have a wall, but the Democrats are told that you can't do that. They are doing a tremendous disservice. The Democrats are doing a tremendous disservice to our country. You heard today about human trafficking. Human trafficking can go down by a tremendous percentage if we had a wall on our southern border. Tremendous. Because it's very hard to do human trafficking through ports of entry. Because you have people standing there looking, and they say, hey, what's going on in the back seat? What's going on in the trunk? They check these things. So they come into areas where you don't have the barriers. And we're not going to let that happen. So we're building a lot of it. We'll be up to about 115 miles of wall, some renovated, some new. And we're going to make a big step in the next week or so prior to my doing anything. But actually having a national emergency does help the process. It would certainly help the process. What would help a lot would be if the Democrats could actually be honest and approve. They're not being honest. Everybody knows they're not being honest. They know they're not being honest. I'd like to hear what they talk about in their rooms when they go back. And I tell you what, a lot of pressure is being put on by Democrats, being put on their leadership. Tremendous pressure is being put on because they cannot justify not having a barrier between our country and Mexico. Mexico just came out yesterday. Numbers were just released. 38,000 people were murdered in Mexico, up like an incredible amount, 30% or something from the year before. 38,000 people were murdered in Mexico. It's one of the most, unfortunately, unsafe countries in the world. We need a protective barrier for our country. And that doesn't include Honduras, who we are not happy with, and we're looking very seriously at taking away all funding. And same thing for Guatemala, and the same thing for El Salvador. It's a disgrace what's going on in those countries. For years and years, the United States has paid them hundreds of millions of dollars, and they do nothing for us. When a caravan starts in the middle of Honduras, obviously they're allowing it to start. And they want it to start because they want to not have certain people in their country. So what do? They put them in the caravan. And we've had tremendous numbers of criminals that we've caught in the caravans before they get here. So the committee is, I know the Republicans want to do something, and I'm not saying it because I'm a Republican. I'm saying the Democrats are instructed, don't do a wall. And they're always doing that. You hear about human trafficking, drugs, gangs, crime. They're only doing it for one very simple reason. It's one simple reason, couldn't be simpler, because they think it's good politics for 2020. Because they say, maybe we can beat Trump. Because this is a big issue. Now, I've done a lot of other issues. I've done military, where our military is in great shape now. It's strong and ready. It was totally depleted when I got here. Regulation cuts, tax cuts. I mean, we've done more than any other president has ever done in the first 2 years of his presidency. But the wall is a big factor, and they want to use the wall for politics. So it's not going to work because we're building the wall, and it's under construction. Yes.
Mr. President, have you privately decided whether or not you will declare a national emergency? And just to clarify.
Have I privately? You know what's in my mind?
Yeah, what's in your mind?
Certainly thinking about it.
You're thinking ahead.
I think there's a good chance that we'll have to do that. But we will, at the same time, be building, regardless, we're building wall, and we're building a lot of wall. But I could do it a lot faster the other way.